First thing on the docket, Trump's campaign star witness in Michigan was deemed not credible. Then her loud testimony went viral. We're in the courtroom. Here we go.
And lots of legal topics.
Election, I will say. These Democrats took every avenue possible to commit fraud in this election. And what I saw on the 3rd and 4th was over 20 counts of fraud.
Take a place.
Would you estimate in front of you that you observed were counted multiple times in the machine? Can you put a number to it, an estimated number?
At least 30,000. That poll book, why don't you look at the registered voters on there? How many registered voters are on there?
How many? I love it.
So she says, "Do you even know the answer to that?"
No, I guess I'm trying to get to the bottom
zero.
Of this here.
Zero. Zero.
The guy asking questions is a Republican.
Trying to take it so serious. Yeah.
What about the turnout rate? 120%.
Why? We're not seeing the poll book off by 30,000 votes. That's not the case.
What did you guys do? Take it and do something crazy to it?
I'm just saying the numbers are not off by 30,000 votes. So
I know what I saw.
That they're filling in.
I know what I saw, and I signed something saying that if I'm wrong, I can go to prison. Mm. Did you?
Rudy Giuliani should be disbarred. And I'm not, like, the longer this has gone on, the more upset I'm getting. Every attorney who is taking these frivolous cases that they know are frivolous, that are specifically designed to undermine our democracy, should be disbarred. Should be disbarred. This is not a frivolous case where you've got a client who's a jerk and they want to try to get more money out of somebody else. This is so much bigger than that.
This is sedition. Yeah.
This is sedition.
What is sedition?
These people.
Can you just define sedition?
Essentially encouraging overthrow or violence.
And you've got people that are using their status as attorneys to help people do this, to give an air of legitimacy to it that is going to do damage for I don't know how long. They should be disbarred, every single one of them.
Yes.
She's just lying. She's lying.
Yeah.
And it's.
As a lawyer, there's two things that fascinate me. Well, one, he shouldn't. The only reason I say that is if she's under oath, I mean, Rudy Giuliani is probably helping her commit perjury. Mm-hmm. Lawyers should not be encouraging people to lie to courts. Court records should typically not have lies in them.
Yeah.
So, not hilarious. The affidavit probably wouldn't, if it was before a real court, I say it because before it looks like a state legislative committee. If it was before a court, she could, I assume these claims are demonstrably false, which is why all these cases keep failing. But she could theoretically be held in contempt or perjury, depending on what she's doing. Her behavior interrupting the judge or interrupting the asker of questions, that was a judge. The judge could put her in jail for contempt because she's being a huge pain. But
you come to a proceeding where you're going to be testifying in like messy bun, chunky scarf.
Yeah.
And then she sounded drunk.
Yeah, I was wondering if she's not drunk. I need to hear her when
she's not drunk. Okay. People say that in the comments. I don't think that woman's drunk.
You don't think she sounded drunk?
I think that that woman's slurring.
No. I don't. I think that that's just how she lives her life.
She's slurring.
Really?
Okay. Yes. If she's not drunk, I want to see her when she is drunk, because you might have like 20 minutes to say something.
Yeah.
I think it's so funny how I don't know. Like, we're giving these people the time of day. Like, I mean, you know, it feels like we're in a different time.
I think it's
time.
A relief that we're making – they're somewhat of a joke.
People are taking it seriously.
But she's before – a legislator called a meeting to have these people talk to
them.
And,
like, I don't know if you saw this one, but one of the people on that board was like, well, first off, you've done a great job testifying.
Hilarious.
Excellent testimony. I can't tell if he was being sarcastic, but I hope –
I hope his tongue was planted firmly in his cheek.
Yeah, like if that guy wasn't being sarcastic, I don't know how he found his way to work in the morning.
Yes.
Yeah.
How a population of people somewhere decided that
I don't know
him.
How he didn't drown in the shower. Looking up.
Where does that?
That's a myth about the turkey.
A myth about the turkey, okay.
I think it's wild because, I mean, obviously she's just making on base claims, you know, but like it's one one of those, I don't know, I feel like if we've gotten kind of used to that in the past 4 years and everybody's kind of just desensitized and now it's just like another day, right? I didn't even hear about this news story. If this happened when Obama was president, like every
his main scandal was wearing a fucking tan suit.
Yeah, and wearing or having mustard on a hot dog instead of ketchup.
Every lawyer, no matter what their law, if they've tried like more than 5-10 cases, they've had a witness like her.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The witness is on the other side, but like Rudy Giuliani, who I think is a terrible lawyer, even he's like, oh shit, my witness is terrible and I need to try to get this thing under control.
Yeah. The thing where he does where he leans over and like taps her, he's and like quiet. Yeah. I have done that so many times.
Yeah.
Really funny.
And it's usually to somebody who's on meth.
Really?
Yeah.
People show up to the courtroom on meth?
Why stop now?
It's gotten you this far.
But no, I mean like they were on it relatively recently.
Gotcha. Okay, meth
has longer effects.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay.
This is what I thought about was estate planning, because without a good plan, or if you're just fighting over most of my longest and somehow most lucrative cases, people are fighting over a will. Or fighting over who should get what, and the witnesses are just as bullshitty as that person. Like, yeah. Imagine if your entire family or your well-being or whatever is based on the testimony of someone who is not credible.
That's a huge point, right? Like, so imagine like the most like unhinged, like emotionally unstable person in your life.
The craziest person in your family.
Right. They probably have a strong sense of entitlement. And that's going to apply to your things, right? So if you don't take care of this, that person, put that person in the driver's seat.
Because
they have
person.
No shame and all of this entitlement on all of your shit.
Yes. Yeah.
Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode of Let's Talk About Death and Taxes, let us know. Post a comment and let us know your thoughts. Guys, if you would like actual legal advice, send us a message. info@letstalkaboutdeathandtaxes.com is the podcast email. You can also give us a call anytime, 404-939-7562. Send us an email to our main firm email at...
info@scriberlaw or info@modernestateplanning, either.
Yeah, .com. Guys, have a great day. Thanks so much for watching.